ste došli biti s nama. Današnji gost na prvoj u novoj sezoni Cruisinga je Uroš Prah. Molim vas pljesak za njega, došao na muzikalicu. Uroš, ja ću opet kao i sa svima vama pročitati vašu kratku biografiju. Bićemo na ti, a govorit ćemo hrvatsko, srpski, engleski, nešto malo slovenskog, a ja ću Urošu pomoći čitati njegovu poeziju koja je prevedena na hrvatski i koja je povod ovog našeg druženja. Znači, nedavno prevedena zbirka poezije Ususret klizeći, koja je dvojezična na slovenskom i na hrvatskom jeziku. Uroš Prah, rođen 1988. studirao je komparativnu književnost i filozofiju u Ljubljani. Moram reći da je diplomirao, da ne ispada da je studirao samo, je li tako? To je opasna konstrukcija, znači da nisi završio. Objavio je dvije zbirke pjesama. Čese polzeći, to ćeš mi ti pravilnije izgovoriti, i tišima. Čese polzeći, ususret klizeći, je ovdje s nama, možete ju uzeti, kupiti, ukrasti. Bio je suosnivač i urednik časopisa i paraliterarne organizacije Idiot, a pjesme iz ove zbirke emitirane su i na trećem programu Hrvatskog radija, te tiskane u časopisu Tema. Uroše, meni se ova zbirka jako svidjela zbog toga što je jako homoerotska i jako fali pandan u balkanskom prostoru poezije, ili sam ja to nekako izbjegao ili je to mene izbjeglo. Zanima me kako je uopće ju bilo pisati. U Sloveniji postoji nešto veća kultura LGBT i poezije i proze. Što je značilo za mladog pjesnika se odlučiti tako eksplicitno ući u ovu temu, ovakvu temu, i kako je taj proces izgledao, evo, za početak? Sad pričaj na kojem god jeziku želiš.
Hoću da počnem na hrvatski, ali neću. Sorry, but I will speak in English because if I try to do it in Croatian, I will lack half of the words. So, yeah. Well, it's about gay writing in the, I don't know, Balkans, Western Balkans, ex-Yugoslavia. I mean, there of course there are good examples, incredible ones, and definitely a big influence for me was Brano Muzetić, which we were talking before about. I don't know if you know him, Slovenian poet, novelist, publisher. He's also my publisher now. Mm-hmm. He published the first and second book. And he was the first, and there was some homoeroticism in Slovenian poetry before, but he was the first one who actually started writing really explicitly at the late 80s. And then all through the 90s and the 2000s, and he is very well translated all over the world. Also in Croatia, you have a few translations of his done by the same translator as Miro Mihaljević. And I remember one incident. The first time I learned about Brane Muzetić was high school. And I was in a big library in Maribor, and I just found in the poetry section, no, in the prose section, I found a book with a, there was like the torso of a young male body with a small cut in it. Mm-hmm. And of course it drew my attention immediately, and so that's how I learned about that. It was one book of his from the 90s. A Slovenian painter did the first page, and who also does amazing homoerotic stuff. And yeah, that was my first introduction to Brane Muzetić. Then I read his stuff, Banalia, for example, which is a very incredible book that you have in Croatian and you should definitely read. And so there was precedent for that. I saw that, oh, you can write like that as well. In terms of the first book that came in Slovenia, it came out, Čese polzeći, in 2012. And at 2008, I co-founded this literature magazine. It was a student magazine at first, later it got away from the student thing, called Idiot, that I left like 2 years ago. And there I was publishing my poetry from the start. And as I was preparing for this book, like a few issues of Idiot were already out, and I had some stuff in every one of them. And as I was going through my past stuff and through some notes and so on, I discovered suddenly that I, as I was publishing stuff in Idiot, I was actually forgetting or suppressing explicit texts. And I didn't forgot about it. Mm-hmm. And so as I was preparing for the book, I think that the best things were explicit and weren't published in Idiot. And then they landed the first third of the book intentionally, of course. Also to, it's the first book is the most explicit, the most, I don't know, classically love poetry. Later it gets more complicated and less homoerotic. But this first third of the book is explicitly like that, and it wants to be like that also to make it a bit harder to enter into the book for readers that have problems with that. So it's a hurdle that you have to either enjoy or get through to get to the other stuff.
Da malo predstavimo tvoj rad, ja bih ipak volio da mi malo čitamo, pa se opet vratimo na razgovor. Ja bih te zamolio da otvoriš 6. stranicu, pročitaš na slovenskom, a ja ću pročitati za tebe na hrvatskom, jer se bojiš akcenata, pa evo, Bog nam pomogao.
This one is untitled. Ti si tisti viharnik za katerega sem mislil, da sem jaz. Kot ste se mi nekoč Robin Hood in Prince lila v eno, kar sem postal jaz sam, ali ko sem hotel biti nogometaš in sem bratu ukradil do kolenke in drkal. Kot sem še nedavno mislil, da sem morda Bal ali Sergio Fantom, tako sem postavil svojo erotično fantazijo, zdaj se lahko mirno zaljubljam, ker vem, da nisem jaz tisto, kar ljubim.
Prijevod treba, jel tako? Ti si taj buntovnik u kojem sam prepoznavao sebe. Kao što su mi se nekoć Robin Hood i Prince topili u jedno, to sam postao ja sam. Ili kad sam htio biti nogometaš, pa sam bratu ukrao dokoljenice i drkao. Kao što sam još nedavno mislio da sam možda Bal ili Sergio Fantom, tako sam postajao vlastita erotska maštarija. Sada se mogu mirno zaljubiti jer znam da nisam ja ono što volim. Koliko je bilo uredničkog posla, koliko si sudjelovao u uredničkom poslu ili je to bilo sve što si poslao pa je bilo sve i objavljeno tim ili nešto drugačijim redoslijedom? Koliko si bio cenzuriran kao gay autor?
Objavio sam kod Braneta Muzetića, nisam bio cenzuriran, znaš.
Ali, pa dobra, autohomofobija zna biti jako opasna.
Ja, ali ne.
Isto,
ne kod Braneta, ne.
Okay.
Trebaš da čitaš njegove stvari, stvarno ne. Ne, i on nije ovakvi uradnik koji bi dosta cenzurao ili mešetario. On treba da sam napraviš ovaj rad kad objaviš kod njega.
Ja što ima? Hrvatsko,
a, te, ali, ima dobre i slabe strane.
Okay,
tako, možda da ne radi dozvom na uredničkim poslima, ali dobro, nema dosta vremena sa svima što radi, tako treba da dolaze stvari na sol. Mm-hmm. Ja. Okay.
Što za tebe znači konstrukcija pjesnik tijela? Jel bih rekao
well,
da si to bio?
I wouldn't say that.
You wouldn't but say that.
Other people did and do. But it's somehow I understand it, especially thinking about the first book, because a lot of topics start from there, a lot of its energy is based from there. A lot of the problematics it opens and describes is maybe could be described as, you know, this small space between two bodies where potentiality exists, and it's this the closeness. The word closeness maybe describes it the best, where it's never really together, that you can't really come close and touch completely. It's also, it's closeness is actually for me a word for distance, the always persisting distance. And maybe from this energy where a whole world can grow in a very tiny space between two bodies, that's the energy this book is taken from. And maybe then that is a okay term, but I wouldn't say I put the body, maybe that's the periphery of the body would maybe be more of interest to me than the body itself.
Je li to karakteristika homoerotske poezije, ta zapravo nikada stvarna bliskost koja se cijelo vrijeme mora opet iznova problematizirati, uvijek taj osjećaj nedostatnosti, nepribliženosti?
Yeah, I mean, of course. Something I always find a bit amusing with cis authors is how they, especially male ones, how they so often in their heavy romanticization of love and intimacy and eroticism and objectivization of the process completely fail to acknowledge that the, I don't know, space of sexuality is a backing ground. Mm-hmm. And that I think that is something LGBTQ author who writes about it seriously can never really forget.
Kako je bilo uspostavljati taj, ajmo ga nazvati, gay glas u tekstu? Što ti je bilo važno da zaobiđeš kao stereotip koji se nužno uspostavlja kada problematiziraš tu jednu vrstu iskustva?
As I was writing these texts, which are quite early for me, so a long time ago, came out 2012, a lot of these texts were written in 2009 or 8 or 7. And I'm 30 now, so I was quite young also then. And back then I wasn't really concerned with these questions. I mean, I did read some gay literature, but not a lot. And so I really disregarded those problems. What? And maybe there are some problems with the book because of that, and also some very fresh perspectives because of that thing. And this was quite a healthy approach. Mm-hmm. And later on, it grew in the second book. It grew and became this space I was talking before grew immensely, and a lot of different problematics that are also already visible here but are much more deeply explored there inhabit the book. So there, I think this question cannot really come up because it's so it twists and turns so much that it's still there always, but it's part of a bigger picture, and yeah, I don't think it's really a concern. But for example, you mean by such cliches? Mm-hmm. What are you thinking about?
Problematiziranje promiskuitetnosti, na primjer.
Aha.
Okay, okay.
Cares about that. No.
46. stranica, čitaj.
Orhis in Orhis. Jaz hodim s Füglerjem, reče, in moja interpretacija je groba. Ljubek je. Bel bi ga poljubljal njegove drobne poteze, ki to ne bi bile več, ker se poveča, kar objameš. Ob stiku obrazu se potepe za stalija. Slika izteče, če je čisto telesno s pogled je izničen. To bi naredil ljubeč še previdno. Komparativist je s hermeneutiko se ukvarja. Nežnost potrebuje. Ko reče mutaš prahe in meodaš prahe z drhtin, tem odnosu bi bil primernejši za vlogo očeta. Zburja me dajati to, kar bi moralo biti dano meni. Njegovi drobni prsti bi obvinili moja jajca, utripajoč tič bi zapolnil njegova ustica. Usedel bi se name, sopihal bi in je čal. Naprej bi se nagnil, se prižel k meni in se nataknil do konca. Cena nam bi brala pred tem. Ljubiti se po njem bi bilo barbarsko. Prišel bi van, na en sok bi se mu podsvetil iz zadnjice. Ljubila bi.
To morate pljeskati, brz da razumijemo. Orhis in Orhis. Hodam sve, gledam Velipa, moja interpretacija gruba. Dražastan je, zagrlio bi ga, poljubio njegove sitne crte lica. Koje to više ne bi bila, jer se ono što zagrliš poveća. Pri dodiru lica crte se stapaju, prizor prelazi u čistu tjelesnost. Pogled je uništen. To bih napravio. S ljubavlju oprezno. Komparatist, bavi se hermeneutikom. Treba nježnost. Kada izgovori muteć prahe ili mordeć prahe, uzdrhtim. U tom bi odnosu bio primjereniji za ulogu oca. Uzbuđuje me činiti ono što bi moralo biti rađeno meni. Njegovi majušni prsti obuhvatili bi moja jaja. Trepereća kita ispunila bi njegova usta. Sjeo bi na mene, dahtao i stenjao. Nagnuo bi se naprijed, privio se uz mene, nabijajući se do kraja. Pritom bi čitao Selana. Voljeti se po njemu bi bilo barbarski. Sišao bi s mene. Naš sok cijedio bi mu se iz stražnice. Voljeli bismo. Ja malo drugčije čitam od tebe.
Naravno.
Možda ovo trebalo biti nježnije, intimnije, ali ja sam malo ovako skloniji teatru dok čitam. Kako je tvoje iskustvo čitanja tvojih tekstova? To je čest problem sa pjesnicima, jer znaju čitati, to sam pitao nekoliko ljudi, znaju čitati vrlo onako posmrtno, tužno, patetično, a zapravo se radi o seksu koji je bio fenomenalan, tu nešto curi iz guzice, sve je super, kužiš, a čitaju kao da je umro neko,
da.
Jel? A
da.
Zapravo ultimativni užitak bio u igri.
Ne, ja imam vrlo različno, okay, I have quite with different kinds of readings. We actually, as a, when we started the magazine, we had a band and we brought new songs, new poems that were made into songs. And so it was very performative and musical at the beginning. And some of the poems, because of that, are incredibly rhythmic in the book. Not the ones we were reading until now, but maybe we will read some that are. I have the cycle from the second book, Obesni Pet, which was also by Romeo translated and published in a few places. Agon and Proletar published it in Croatian. For example, I read that at a tour in Zagreb and in Belgrade and in Rijeka and so on. And this is, for example, a very performative text that goes way up and down. So sometimes I read, sometimes a bit more reserved. It depends also on the setting and have to only read or so on. So I don't have a problem with it at all. I think it's necessary. I mean, it's a part of the game.
Ja bih rekao da uvodiš i trans identitet, odnosno trans estetiku, a ti ćeš me sada ispraviti da li je tome tako kada pročitaš pjesmu na stranici 31.
Prebude na kraljični. To je jedan tistih tipov, ki pravijo, da bi bili porno zvezde. Tišijo glave v zidove, riti pa v zrak in te prosijo, da jih pofukaš. Potem hropejo od užitka. Šepetajo ti, da jih čudno zbode, ko jim ga zarine že do konca. Pobarvani dolgi lasje z osameljimi kocinami psuti obrazi. Proč se obračajo. Zid v rjuho, v strop. Čez rob postelje k oknu iz tedeni vratovi, izbočene kite na njih. Luno lovijo široko odprtimi usti. Takrat je, ko se zazdijo lepi. Ko so lepi, ko so angeli popolnih teles, vsi napeti in mehki in srečni. Njihovi črni lasje se leskatajo takrat, kot omotične vrane na rosnih cmuriških poljih.
Probušene kraljevne. To je jedan od onih tipova koji govore da žele biti porno zvijezde, guraju glave u zidove, guzice dižu u zrak i mole te da ih pošeliš. Potom stenju od užitka, šapću ti da ih čudno pecne kad im ga gurneš do kraja. Obojene duge kose, lica pokrivena rijetkim maljama, okreću se. Prema zidu, prema plahtama, prema stropu. Preko ruba postelje ka prozoru ispruženi vratovi, dignutih kita. Mjesec love široko otvorenih usta. Tada se učine lijepima, kada su lijepi. Kada su anđeli savršenih tijela, svi napeti, meki i sretni. Njihova crna kosa tada se sjaji poput ošamuđenih vrana na rosnim, smureškim poljima. Je li ovo trans ili nije?
Ne, nije. Ali ima trans mjestima, ne ovo, ne toliko, drugi više, ali gdje se spol, samo spol, ne, identiteta tako mijenjuje u pjesmu mnogo puta, ali ne to. Tu je samo kraljev nekako.
Koliko si puta u svom umjetničkom i intelektualnom životu morao objašnjavati razliku između spola i roda?
Pa, ne. Ne rad ovo radim, tako da, mislim, nije potrebno dosta puta, ali, znaš, odvisno od settinga, ove pitanja dosta puta, u settingu gdje se to ne razumije, ne dolaze do ovih pitanja, znaš?
Teatar ti je također važan motiv u poeziji.
No.
Ne bi to rekao.
No, to je to lakše.
Ne? Ali kada izvodiš svoju poeziju, ona je bila mišljena za scenski događaj.
No.
Nije?
No.
A što ste radili sa svojim koncertima? Što je to bilo?
Da, bili su performativni muzičarski settingi. Aha. Ali i nešto malo poezije tu je tako. Mm-hmm. Ali nije nikada bilo with that in mind. Mm-hmm.
Ali ljubav i seks jesu izvedbe koje smo naučili u životu, zar ne? Koje reproduciramo u svakodnevnom.
Malo, nekoliko procenta jesu, ali nije samo to. Mm-hmm. I everything is performative. Mm-hmm. The act of writing is performative, the act of reading is performative, the act of thinking is. We all always try to achieve certain performative norms while doing any kind of thing. Mm-hmm. But it is not my main preoccupation and concern to problematize that.
Možeš li govoriti nešto o iskustvu pisanja na početku i iskustvu pisanja sada i šta znači zapravo danas za tebe istraživati u polju poezije?
Yes.
Sada kada osvajaš drugi jezik, a to je njemački jezik na kojemu pišeš.
Right now I'm actually working on my third and my fourth book. The third one will come out next year in Slovenia, in Slovene. And the fourth one the year after that in Austria, in German. So I'm writing in German as well. Now bilingual poet, or two poets in two different languages. It's, in German there is quite a complete different kind of writing. In Slovenia there is an evolvement from the second, from the first to the second and third book, definitely. Continuity and also discontinuity that can be observed, but with German writing it's a completely different world. It's much more journalistic poetry, I would say. It's much more research based in certain topics that are socio-political. Mm-hmm. I don't do that at all in the Slovenian poetry I write. So it's funny how with different contexts as well I write differently for different readerships, different literary markets and so on. Yeah.
S kime sugovoriš? Naprimjer, Herta Miller je rekla da kada je počela stvarno pisati na njemačkom, da je isto morala ući u dokumentarnu.
Da, somehow it really, the German mindset is somehow the Austrian one. It demands more, I think. I mean, I like to, I mean, I always like to go against the grain, and for example, in Austrian and German poetry now, it's very rare to write like that in poetry. So much more. It's much more language-based, experimental. If talking about socio-political topics, it's more coded. Basically, no one I read writes like I write now in German, and I immediately started to go in the opposite direction as they do. I felt it's necessary for the space I'm writing in. So yeah, it's very. It came about because there is a small publishing house in Vienna, Exil Verlag, that has like an annual prize for poetry and for prose and for drama for authors who write in German as their second language. And so one afternoon I wrote a few poems in German and sent them, and I got the first prize, and that's now we were working on a book with them. And so that's how it came about. What I submitted, because it is a Exil Verlag and they have this focus anyway, I submitted a text about basically modern day Austrian colonization in Romania and by wood company Schweighöfer, that is basically cutting down all the prime forests of Romania illegally, and at the same time Austrians proud themselves of high sustainability in their own country and so on. So it was basically almost a news article in poetry form about that, quite thoroughly research as well. Mm-hmm. And so that's what I write in German. So it's completely different from what it is.
74. strana koja je možda anticipirala ovo što sada radiš, a da nisi ni znao.
Plastenje. Če si koža papir, in če spodaj papir, in bolj spodaj tudi, in ga še niže še več, in pod njim usnje, pod njim pa les in beton in zrak, les in beton in zrak, les in beton in zrak, les in beton, polno betona in je zemlja pod njim in pod zemljo, kdo bi vedel, kaj je pod zemljo, kako globok bo vres, kako globok, te sprašujem, da bodo mesa.
Raslojavanje. Ako si koža papir, i ako je ispod papir i još ispod, a ispod ga je još više, a pod njim koža, a ispod nje drvo i beton i zrak, drvo i beton i zrak, drvo i beton i zrak, drvo i beton, puno betona, a zemlja je pod njim i pod zemljom, tko zna što je pod zemljom, koliko dubok će biti rez, koliko dubok pitam te da dođeš do mesa. Nije sva poezija homoerotska. Ipak si prošvercao i nešto nehomoerotskog u ono što se tvrdi da je eksplicitno homoerotska poezija.
Ja ne, I never started writing with the intention of it being homoerotic. It's my eroticism is mostly homoerotic, so it's homoerotic, but I also write about different others.
Je li sada drugčije pristupaš pisanju? Da li pristupaš sa više namjere od ove prve autentične zbirke? Jer prva knjiga
nema autenticizma, ništa nije autentično. Mm-hmm. I ne vjerujem u ovaj koncept. Mm-hmm. And I hate it and I despise it, and I wrote a whole master thesis against it. So authenticism, I think it's something to be destroyed. Mm-hmm. It's an attack for the lack of it. Mm-hmm. Basically, it's a concept used heavily by, especially in literature theory, but also in marketing these days and in politics and so on, in order to arrive at a place where you don't have to talk about the complexity of stuff. So I never had much much intention to write authentically or to think about something being authentic. Authentic to what or to whom? I mean, writing is depersonalization in any case. And when I write, I think it's my way of dealing with the violence of language. But by that I mean language is the violence of naming things first and foremost, the power relations that contract in language, and how to deal with it, how to at sometimes potentialize it, but also how to de-weaponize it.
Kada sam te pitao za autentično, mislio sam na to nemišljenje o strukturi i cjelovitosti dijela koje si isporučio kao prvu knjigu. U tom smislu postoji nešto zaista bitno manje patvoreno u tom procesu, nego li će ikada biti više ikada u jednom drugom, u svim drugim knjigama.
I also don't think that, I mean, I think first my approach to making a book is never wholesome from the beginning. I don't think one can write such a poetry book and it being good, especially for me, I cannot and I don't want to. So I produce a lot of material, not that much. I'm not a massive writer. I'm not an overwriter who has to write all the time in order to exist. I'm not one of those. I write in bursts, in outbursts from time to time, mostly, and a lot of fragments in various different directions, and then I start to work on a book and I order them into a whole and into a, that makes sense. And I think it grows into a whole. And for example, in Tishima, in the second book, it grew into a whole of three parts, which are quite distinct from each other, connected, but in a dialogue with each other, but are distinctly three. In Tishima, it's more cycles that are intermittent, and I have it here. It's also how I placed it like that, how I placed it. That's the second book in Slovene, Tishima. And if you look at it, it's placed like that. And it's graphically, it becomes, it's, they are all like fleeing from each other, the poems. There are some intermittent ones, but otherwise they're always on the edges. And they form, that's also a way how they form a whole. I think, the logic of making it a whole comes in post-production, let's say. And then some new texts also are written in order to make the holes whole. But yeah, that's how I still write and intend to.
Nadam se da će ona biti prevedena na hrvatski.
A part of it is.
Ali mislim kao cjelovita knjiga.
A part of it is translated by Romeo also for some years now, and it's like I said, it's published in Tema. I think it's from the second book, actually. I'm not sure. But definitely in Agon and in Proletar, parts of it are published in Croatian.
Tako sam te i otkrio u srpskim književnim časopisima. 96. stranica. Sve razumijete, jel smo tihi, glasni, vi idete, bok, hvala, čao.
Cmurek 2. Sve mi je dano. Svit, otrok, zemlje, prah, van, mi učite jemlje, ker ih ne smijem imeti. Tekst mam, ki se plete, se vzoči in dela moj čas. zaenkrat se ne bom zmedil samega sebe, če prav vem, da tudi ta trenutek prihaja. Za zdaj je treba živeti. Prečuti umeje, stopa v nanje, za njihov čestnje. Trlo je beseda, trlo je beseda, trlo je beseda. Leta bodo stekla, s tabom kristalno čisti mrzli vodi, čez proti in čez prste in prste v proti in tma in not.
Smurek 2. Sve mi je dano, svijet, dijete, zemlje, prašina, ono što mi uzima očeve jer ih ne smijem imati. Imam tekst koji se plete, stvara uzorke, proizvodi moje vrijeme. Odjednom se neću moći riješiti samoga sebe, iako znam da se taj trenutak bliži. Za sada treba živjeti. Osjetio granice, gazio ih, zanjihao se preko njih. Tijelo je riječ, tijelo je riječ, tijelo je riječ. Godine će odjuriti. Stajat ću u kristalno čistoj ledenoj vodi. Kroz šljunak i kroz prste, i prste u šljunak, i mrak, i unutra. Što znači Cmurek?
Cmurek je my hometown.
Okay.
Village I grew up in.
Okay.
So there's, yeah. Also, the second book, there is Cmurek 3 and Cmurek 4. somehow it continues, it morphs. Yeah. Every time some motifs from this village come up, I title it Cmurek and put a number on it.
Hoće li ti seoski motivi probiti u jednoj zbirci do kraja gdje ćeš pisati o svinjama, kravama, kozama koje su trčale
nije, okolo? Nije ih bila tamo. Ne, nije bila takva vlast. It won't never morph into a full book, I think. It's always snippets that uh-huh. come up in some contexts. Here I see something that's lost in translation here in this one. When I say text mom, which is here imam text,
mm-hmm.
Is mom. It's a slang
mm-hmm.
for imam, but it's also mom as in mama.
Mm-hmm.
It's
mm-hmm.
It's something that got lost, but mm-hmm. yeah.
Zato što ova naša regija, uključujući i Mađarsku, većina živućih pisaca u nekom trenutku zaista napiše ili zbirku poezije ili prozno djelo gdje tematizira svoje seosko
okolično,
blato, komarce, džubre koje smrdi, stranice.
I grew up in this little village on the border with Austria, next to a river, with lots of greenery all around, and below a big castle in which there was a mental institution, next to a granični prelaz, which was heavily militarized in a certain time and so on, and there was we had the territorial obramba when there was, you know, the short war going on, and we had a lot of smuggling there. It was a crazy little place. The punk started in Slovenia there,
really?
And so on. It was a crazy little. It was like a very urbanized village.
Okay. Cmurek.
Quite weird.
Okay.
Yeah. And of course it comes up all the time. Right. Parts of it, yes.
Ne, ja sam odrastao na Manhattanu, pa ne znam o čemu, ali vjerujem ti, da. Molim te, broj 12. Koliko ima stanovnika Cmurek?
It's quite spread out on hills, so it doesn't really feel like a village. Mm-hmm. But I say it's like 80 maybe altogether. Yeah.
80?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, but it's really, really spread out. and our house is like very close to the border crossing,
okay.
where there was like a bar and a shop and like a little center around the smuggling place. 12? Yeah. Sklonjeno glavo čepiš pred menoj, skunice nosuti visi kaplja in na korenu čaka druga in jaz čakam, da se združita in padeta in zlepita prah na parketu.
Pognute glave čučiš predamnom, s vrha nosa visi ti kapljica, na korijenu visi duga, druga. a ja čekam da se sjedine i padnu i slijepe prašinu na parketu. Ova pjesma se mogla zvati Sperma.
Ali ne zove se.
Ali se ne zove. Zašto nisi htio
ima našo.
Ima našo. Molio bih te još da nam pročitaš prije nego što te pustimo na miru. 78. stranica.
Zilje, sem danes na tržnico šel in je sonce sijalo, me je veter dobil, zvečer pa prehlad. Sem legel, sem gledal, sem blodal, sem blodil. In noč. Mesto je bočnovla megla požrla, sneg še leži in šmrknem in švrknem z roko do okna, sta skupaj mašina zaškrta, ga čaka, me zgrabi kot io, me zvije modrina, gostote bencina in mraza, predajam recini poraza, česujem, ginjujem in skoraj več ne.
Kupus.
Tviske je punk sam, mislim.
Pošao sam danas na tržnicu i sjalo je sunce, uhvatio me vjetar, a navečer prehlada. Legao sam, gledao, glodao, tumarao i noć. Grad je bučen, samo magla koja sve guta. Snijeg još leži, šmrcnem i udarim. Rukom u prozor, u zajednosti stroj. Čekam ga da me zgrabi kao i u. Sakrije me plavet, gustoće benzina i mraza. Predaja, strvini poraza, tavorim, nestajem. Skoro me više nema.
Ja, ove, ova...
Šta?
Dosta ritma gubi se u ovom...
U hrvatskom.
Ja.
Nisi zadovoljan?
Ne, sa ovom nisam najviše. Ali evo.
Ajmo onda još ovu Lenju.
Lenju. Lenju. Lenju.
Ajde se probaj na hrvatskom to pročitati. Jer se zove Ljenčina,
Ljenčina,
a ti si Ljenčina da govoriš na hrvatskom iako ga razumiješ.
Imam ga cijelo vrijeme dok ga ne ponestane. Zato u stalnom iščekivanju sranja jer odgađam što bih morao učiniti, ali ništa. Odgurujem zadatke od sebe da se pretvore u problem. Odgurujem dalje dok to ne prestanu biti. Pita odvjetnika. Poraz koji još nije poraz za prava je pobjeda. Što jest, jest. Kad se nešto mora dogoditi, bit će.
Sjajno. Bravo. Ajde još jednu na hrvatskom i puštam te na miru. Čekaj, da ću ti malo veću. Jedriličaru. 45. Samo se opusti.
Znaš što? Ako želite, možem napraviti. A kad ovo, pa stvarno dosta sam čitao, iz druge knjige.
Dobro.
Da objasni pet cikla.
Dobro.
I to, to bi znao da pročitam, ali
pa
treba da pronađem. Treba da idem na Agon. A malo više, ali ako imamo toliko vremena.
Imamo.
Već to ne znam, pravda, 5 godina što sam to nazad ne čitao.
Šta ja čitam dok ti tražiš?
Možem.
Evo, jedriličaru. Ozdravio sam spustivši te u ljetno poslijepodne široko otvorenih prozora. Ozona na rubu ljubljanske medine s Matejem i Mirtom. Mir je sa mnom. Kad se sljedeći put sretnemo, kakve večeri, izbliza ću pogledati tvoje dlanove. Ureze konopca, u njima tražiti kristale soli, majušne, svjetlucave stope, preplovljene sreće. Jeste li našao?
Mm-mm.
Nije.
Ne.
Ajde, ona ipak što morate ovo čitati.
Ne nađem. Onda ništa.
Evo ti zadnja za čitanje. Može?
Može. Kira.
Child in Time. Mm-hmm. 71.
Što na hrvatskom? Child in Time. u rascijepljenoj sobi, u nekoj knjizi na polu udubljenoga, u filter degradiranoga, jedva još čovjeka. Ja mladoga ja, niti na putu, niti na mjestu, tek malo iznad grada, tamo negdje u visini smoga, pod zvijezdama, pod oblacima, sateliti ili ispod toga pogledaj cijeli puni mjesec, daleko, daleko ispod mjeseca. S bljedim slikom humanizma među drugim bljedima i kako brzo pod slikama koje klize u zjenicama, s vjerom u ono čemu su ga učinile žene, dok se gubio pod određenim kutom u toj mutnoj kroz posve otvoren prozor, dolazeće je svjetlo, svjetlosti lijepoga, u razohovljenoj hibernaciji na sve spremnoga mladog čovjeka. Vidim.
Pa kada si iz Zagorja, super. Sve okej. Okay. Hvala ti puno. Ukoliko ima pitanja, pitajte ga, ukoliko nema, možemo nastaviti dalje.
Ja mi jedu.
Ići na pivo, izvoli.
Ajde. Mene zanima da se na početku morao rješavati nekakvog viška u svom jeziku. Ili ti je početka ovako čisti, jasan. Znači, mislim, recimo, ja nemam još mnogo poezije kako čitam na hrvatskom ili hrvatskom prijevodu, recimo, to mi se odmah sviđalo, jer je onako baš pandovski čista, ima onako malo pridjeva.
A, da.
Svaki redak je ili ima neki glagol, nešto se događa, ili ima neku jasnu sliku, onako vrlo je
da.
U čvrstim nekakvim konturama.
Da,
to je prirodno.
Dobro pitanje, da. It's, actually tried to write like that, I always did. I don't know what came first, my trying to write like that or my having to write like that and then forming it into a concept. I'm not sure which came first, but definitely it is a goal of mine. The German word for poetry, I really like, it's Dichtung, which means two things, poetry at one, but also condensing, and I completely regard it as that. I hate when there is too much on a page. I despise it, and I cut it away. And this was also my editorial work. As I had the magazine, I was quite cruel with the scalpel to text. And I think there has to be a lot of work put to the side of the reader. So there has to be poetry is more about what not to say than what to say. So there has to be a lot of space in which the reader has to work for the poem to work. And that's also what the stuff often is fragmentary. Why I often, already in the first book, but especially in the second one, often do that I start a poem and it develops a momentum. It could go on for 3, 4, 5 times longer and finish itself off in a nice way. And I deliberately said finish itself off there, and it's I don't let it. After its first fifth, I break it off. I cut it away. I force it into a different direction, and it makes for a very interesting effect, I think, for the poem itself, for the reader, and for me.
Malo još pitanja. Izvoli.
Koja je tebi osobna pjesma najdraža u
Pa ne znam. Čekaj.
Ali moraš upočitati.
Dugo je da sam to pisao. I really liked Cmurek 2, which we read. Actually, it's very important. And also fine.
I šta znači da kada voliš neku svoju pjesmu, iz čega to je?
I don't know, it still speaks to me heavily.
Aha.
Yeah.
Okay.
And it still thinks it finds new iterations still in what I write now.
Ili to često, to novo pjesama koje voliš, ili to dosta mali broj?
Mali broj. Naravno, you know, after you finish a book and then the whole shebang about it starts, then it starts all the promotion, all the readings and everything, and you already hate it when you finish it. You hate it so much, you've seen the text so many times, you cannot. And then you have to reread it again and again. It's actually quite refreshing now to come back to a book after so many years, now that this finally came out. Because it kind of, I have to learn to love it again a little bit, you know, a love-hate relationship within, you know, you yourself in the first book, which is always a bit.
Choose the most loved one after Cmurek, the second one.
Cmurek can actually my Museum of Madness nowadays.
Yeah, I co-created it. Yeah. Well, this is the mental institution in the castle I was talking about. Nice that you heard of it. Yeah, it's so I grew up under this total institution. As I said, there were 80 people in the whole village all together, and in the 90s, where it had the most patients, there were more than 350 patients living there, and more than 120 people working there. So it was a huge beast, but the total institution completely closed off from everything. Like, it was like a black hole in the middle of town. Yeah, and they closed down in 2004 as the first total institution, mental institution in Slovenia that closed down. And the process should go on, but they haven't closed anything afterwards. And it stood empty for 10 years, and then we formed a local group in order to revive it, to start inhabiting it and filling it with content. And we developed a concept and also started to implement it, of an interdisciplinary research and social and art center that would deal with madness and would have an international interdisciplinary research center on the topic of madness, would have like an independent watchdog for the process of deinstitutionalization in Slovenia and the region, and an art center with different projects and a gallery and so on. And one of the first things we did was with Idiot, our magazine, we started to have workshops there. We were actually the first one who stayed there over a few nights for the first time after the patients and were writing and so on. And the project is still going on, and it's an incredible project with a lot of endorsement from the international scientific community. Unfortunately, it has a heavy opposition from a few ministries in Slovenia, so it's at a stale place. It has a few supporters there, but it's at a stale place. It cannot move right now into the next stage. So a lot of research programs with international universities are already going on. Art programs are already going on, but its status and its future is very precarious. We don't know whether it's. Yes. Yeah. But it's trying to sell it still. We actually managed to cancel a sale that was already in process two times already. Well, some Austrian casino guy tried to buy it for free, basically, and put hookers inside, and
Read us the last song, please.
Oh, yeah.
the loved one.
I will read the last one. So.
Okay.
Tetris. Što više gradim, veća je sve. Iz prepletenja praznina.
Hvala ti. Da im stvarno je tako. Hvala što si došao, a sad ćemo družiti. Možete ići s nama svi.
Imam.
Eto ga, teta.